Morning, boys and girls. Welcome to our online service this morning. I'm Teacher Bonnie and I'm joined by our lovely Pastor Esther. Karibu sana.
Hi everyone. Everyone at home. Good morning, boys and girls, moms and dads, uncles, aunties, everyone. Good morning.
Good morning. We are always excited every Sunday morning to host you and to share the word of God with you. And so today I would like Teacher Esther to pray for us as we begin.
Okay, this is what we do when we start to pray. Put our hands together, close our eyes, and bow our heads. But before we bow our heads, I want you to turn to your neighbor and say, we are praying.
We are praying.
Okay, so Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this new week. Thank you, Lord, that you've kept us safe and protected and well. We thank you, O Lord God, that you have been God in our lives. In everything that we have done this week, Lord God, we know that you are there and we recognize that you have been with us. Heavenly Father, we pray for this lesson today. We pray, Lord God, that you open the hearts and the minds of each and every child to receive what you have to speak to them today. Heavenly Father, we pray for the families at home, for their provision, Lord God, be their Jehovah Jireh, be their healer, O Lord God, and be the one who gives them comfort and peace throughout this week. So it's with our extreme thanks to you that we say in Jesus' name, Amen.
And I hope you're learning something during discovery time. Are we? I hope they are. Yeah. So we're going to dive right through into our discovery time. And you remember last Sunday? Well, today my t-shirt says something different. Yeah. So we are kids.
Yes.
But do you remember our theme for the month? Anyone? Just so you don't tell us.
Yes, my God is
awesome. Awesome is our God, isn't it? So we'll continue learning about how awesome our God is. And to start us off, Pastor Esther will try and tell us how Jesus grew up like. So today we're going to talk about growing up like Jesus, because I would want to grow up like Jesus, isn't it? Yeah. So I know we are taught, and the Bible says that Jesus grew up in wisdom, in stature, and in favor with God and man. But what does that really mean?
Okay, what we're going to start with is the first part, and that's about wisdom. Yeah. So generally, what I think is that when I think a child is wise, I feel that that child has knowledge of schoolwork. Probably they do things at home really well, yeah? But the Bible tells us the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom, yeah.
I get it now. But when you talk about fear, at times, like, I remember when I was a child, I'm sure even you boys and girls at home, when maybe you're punished or when you see something, you get fearful of something, yeah? You just get afraid. So is that the kind of fear that we should have?
No, it's not the fear that you are scared. Mm-hmm. This fear, as we have said it before, is being in awe of God. The word awesome.
Ah.
Awe. It's like saying, wow. You know, we all admire his creation.
Yeah.
We admire when we see sunsets, when we see sunrises, when we go to the ocean. I mean, it's like, wow.
Yeah.
So this fear is to respect him, to honor him, to obey him. That's the kind of fear that each and every child should have. Mm-hmm. And that's where our wisdom starts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Amazing. So you see, parents, it is our mandate to actually teach our children who God is. And they will learn this by seeing us reading the Word of God, you know, praying, and that way they'll imitate what we are doing.
Yeah, I just want to say, I want to read a verse from the book of Romans, and it's in chapter 11, verse 33 to 36. And I thought the Message version was really nice. So this is what it says, verse 33. Have you ever come on anything quite like this? Extravagant generosity of God, this deep wisdom. It's way over our heads, we'll never figure it out. Is there anyone around who can explain God? Anyone smart enough to tell him what to do? Anyone who has done him such a huge favor that God asked to ask his advice? Is there anyone? Everything comes from him, everything happens through him, everything ends up with him. Always glory, always praise. Yes, yes, yes. So, just to end our discovery session, I would like to tell the parents what they need to teach their children. Teach them that God is the source of everything. Everything that you see, everything that you know, everything that you're going through, it comes from God. And He has you. He has your family. He has you as a person. Teach them that Jesus is the perfect model, yeah, of how we're supposed to live. Our title is Growing Up Like Jesus. And teach them we are not perfect, but if we ask God, He will help us. So, in the end, it's what? How can we become like Jesus? We just need to apply the Word of God. Everything that we are teaching you here and your parents are teaching you at home concerning God, that's where your wisdom comes from. And then you will grow up like Jesus. Yay!
Amazing, amazing. Thank you, Pastor Esther. Isn't that wonderful? At least we've learned how to grow like Jesus. And we'll continue this again next Sunday, yeah? I'm sure you're learning something. So I want us to go right into our little angels class. And I have a surprise for you. Wait and see who will be teaching you.
Surprise, surprise.
Sacrifice was lit up by God, but the enemy's sacrifice was not lit up by their God. And what I had learned is God is awesome and mighty. And the memory verse is Psalms chapter 47 verse 2. It says, "For the Lord Most High is awesome, the great King over all the earth."
My name is called Jolene Price, and I love Jesus, and I have a memory verse, and I'm born again. Psalms 47 verse 2, it says, "The Lord Most High is awesome, the great King over all the earth." Thank you.
Hi, my name is John Benjamin. I'm born again. I love Jesus. I fellowship at the Papa Center Church, and I have a memory verse. Psalms 47 verse 2, it says, "For the Lord Most High is awesome, the great King over all the earth." Thank you.
My name is Jaden Itambo.
What's your name? Tal?
My name is Tal.
Yes. Can you say a memory verse?
Yes, you can tell a memory verse.
Okay, for the Lord?
For the Lord Most High is awesome. And then great.
Great.
King in all of
height. In all the earth.
All the earth.
Okay. Elsie Michelle, I have two memory verses and one song. My memory verses come from the book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 6, and it says, "Don't be anxious about anything, but in everything, with prayer, petition, and thanksgiving, make your request known to God." Psalms chapter 47 verse 2, and it says, "The Lord Most High is awesome, the great King over all the earth." Hakuna kama wewe, 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 hakuna kama wewe,
hakuna kama wewe, hakuna kama wewe.
Tunainama,
tunainuka tukisema,
wewe ni Mungu.
Tunaino matunaino katukisema kuna kama wewe. Tunaino katukisema. Tunaino matunaino katukisema kuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Kama wewe. Kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe.
King of kings, we call you El Shaddai. You are the beginning and the end. We worship and exalt your name, for you are most high. I bring my Sunday school teachers before you, my friends and relatives, parents, teachers and our pastors. May your protection and guidance be with them. I commit our country before you, that you may set us free from this pandemic and bring us back to our normal lives. Forgive us all our wrongdoings and shine your light upon our paths. Thank you, Lord, for you are worthy of praise and adoration. Bless us throughout today. In Jesus' name I pray and believe.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. God loves us all. Stay safe. Thank you. Mwah.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Good morning, boys and girls, and here's a surprise I was talking about, that I will be your teacher for today. I'm Teacher Bonnie, and I'm joined by Kobe.
Good morning, boys and girls. I am happy to see you again. Teacher, I just love the song we sang.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Kobe, I did too. Now, are the boys and girls able to tell us what our lesson for today is all about? Anyone who has a guess?
Teacher, I can try. Is it about shining my light?
Correct, Kobe. Today, we will learn about being the light, and we will also learn about being the salt as well.
Teacher, did you just say salt?
Yes, I said salt.
How do we become salt? Is it like what happened to Lot?
Kobe, no. Let me explain. I hope we have our Bibles. Does everybody have their Bible?
I have my Bible, teacher.
Well done. So, our Bible lesson for today is from the first book in the New Testament, which is?
Matthew!
Good, Kobe. We will read from Matthew chapter 5, from verse 13 to 16. So, you see, in the Bible, Jesus talked about us being the salt and of the earth. So, you see here, I have salt. We all know what salt is used for in our houses, isn't it? So the common use of salt in our houses is to flavor our food. Have you ever eaten food that required salt, but it did not have any? Was it yummy?
No! I like my chips with salt.
Mm-hmm.
Even nyama choma. That is well seasoned with salt. It is very yummy.
Okay, Kobe.
Teacher, wait. Uh-huh. And avocado.
Oh.
And teacher.
Yes.
Okay. Only that.
Kobe has many ideas of how he would want to have his food with salt. Okay, Kobe, I think we get it now. That salt either makes our food delicious or also too much of salt. It will make it bitter and yucky. And you can't eat it, your food, without salt, isn't it? So also Jesus taught us that if salt loses its saltiness, it should be thrown out.
I would not want that, teacher.
Yes, Kobe. You see, salt also has many good uses in our lives. But I want us to understand why Jesus was comparing us to salt. It is because salt makes a lot of difference, either good or bad. And as children, Jesus wants us to flavor other people's lives. So how do we do that?
Teacher, like, when one is sad, you cheer them up and that brings joy in their life. And also, when someone is not getting something for the first time, for example, if they don't know how to spell a word, or wash dishes, or wipe the table, do not laugh at them. Instead, we teach them how to do it and be patient with them. They will feel love and will have learned something new.
Correct, Kobe. Just like salt brings flavor to our food, you will have added joy and something new to someone else, yeah? So, let us continue with our Bible lesson. On the other part, Jesus continues to tell us in verse 14 to 16 that we need to let our light shine before others.
Teacher, is that why you have a flashlight with you?
Yes, Kobe. I brought this flashlight to show you how we are to be the light. Imagine, is everybody imagining? You're in a dark room. Are you afraid of the dark?
Teacher, I'm not afraid of the dark.
That's good, Kobe. Well, some kids I know at home might be afraid of the dark. But you see, if you have the flashlight with you, what would you do?
I will switch it on and there will be light in the room.
Yes, you see, kids, that's the same thing that Jesus wants us to do. He wants us to be like the flashlight, or a candle, or a bulb, and shine the light everywhere where there is darkness. Meaning, if you see others doing bad things, don't join them. Instead, show them the right way of doing things that are pleasing to God.
Teacher?
Yes?
And boys and girls, put your hands on your eyes. What do you see?
I can't see anything.
Are you sure?
Yes, I can't see. It's so dark.
Okay, then remove. Can you see the light?
Yes, I can see, Kobe.
This means that we also have a choice in our hands, either to see the light or darkness, and see the good in others too, and lead them in doing only that which is good.
Thanks, Kobe. I now understand as well. So, it also means that if you cover your light like this, see, I have a cloth. If you cover your light, it also means that you don't want to share your gifts with others, and that is not right.
Yes, we should share with others all that God has done for us, and that way we'll be shining our light.
True. It also means that when we believe in Jesus, who is the light of the world, we too become like him. And so we too need to shine like Jesus.
Teacher,
yes?
How do we shine like Jesus?
We can do so by, one, telling others about Jesus, helping others, being kind, loving others, even when they're not kind to us.
Teacher, I also know another one. Also, by obeying my parents and not talking back to them, forgiving one another when someone has wronged me, and also say sorry when I'm wrong. One more, teacher.
Okay.
By not being jealous of my sister, brother, or friend when they are being appreciated. Instead, I should be happy for them.
Boys and girls, let us be the salt and light to others and stand out from the rest. Let our parents see something different in us this week. And now, for our take-home paper, I want you to show you what Kobe did. As usual, Kobe does his work so well. And this is what we are going to do for this coming week. Yeah? Isn't his work beautiful? I want you to do the same or even better. And then share with us your finished work. Now I want Kobe to lead us with the memory verse for today.
Our memory verse is from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 16. It says, in the same way, let our light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven.
Amazing. I want us to repeat again after Kobe. Kobe, will you lead us one more time?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, then we will repeat after you.
Okay. Matthew chapter 5.
Matthew chapter 5,
verse 16.
Verse 16.
It says,
it says,
in the same way,
in the same way,
let your light shine,
let your light shine
before others,
before others,
that they may see,
that they may see
your good deeds,
your good deeds,
and praise your Father in heaven,
and praise your Father in heaven.
Yay!
Well done, Kobe. And so before we pray and end our lesson for today, I want that all of us make sure that we redo this lesson with our parents, yeah? Make sure you redo with your parents. And then Kobe is going to pray for us, and then we will go for praise and worship and join Teacher Judy, Teacher Knight, and Teacher Keza. Kobe, pray.
Okay, let us pray. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for showing us that we are the light and salt of the earth. We pray that we learn this all through the week. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Praise God Sunday School. Join me for praise and worship with Teacher Judy, Teacher Knight, and Kobe. Get some space and let us dance for the Lord. Amen. Let me see you dance.
I don't know where I'd be without you.
Let's sing it time.
and for your grace. I don't know where I'd be without you.
One more time.
Lord, you are awesome.
Standing is awesome.
Lord, you are awesome.
Standing, how awesome he is.
Not a loser. I am a victor and not a victim. I have changed my mind and my attitude to reflect what God says about me. My faith is built on God's word. I can do all that God says I can do. Nothing is impossible from this moment on, for I am a new breed, a new kind, a remnant, and I am after my papa.
Good morning, boys and girls. Welcome to the Saints and Disciples class for ages 7 to 12. Now, I hope you have your Bibles with you and your notebooks and your pens or pencils. You have them? Good. Now, let's start. Now, before we start, let's pray. All right? Okay. Let's bow our heads and pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning with thanksgiving in our hearts, O God. We want to thank you for the gift of life, the gift of good health. Thank you for enabling us to be here this morning, to come and hear your word, O God. Grant that everything that we speak today and we learn today, God, may bear fruit in our hearts and that we may apply it in our lives. We pray all this, believing and trusting in your name. Amen. Amen. Okay, now, boys and girls, who was here last week, or who's, for who is this the first time? If this is your first time, welcome to Saints and Disciples. But if you were here last week, you remember our lesson on Elijah and how Elijah had the great showdown on Mount Carmel. And we remember that his actions actually led other people to worship God. And that was a good thing, right? But I also gave you homework. I don't know if you remember the homework I gave you. Yes, to identify examples of modern day idols. Did you identify any? Maybe you can tell the person you're with, whether it's your sibling or your mother or your father, your grandmother, your grandfather. Did you get some? What did you get? Nice. Okay, I got TV because sometimes you can be watching something. Maybe you're watching football, for those who like football, or you're watching a movie instead of reading the Bible. When it's time to pray, you're watching a cartoon or something. Then there are things like phones, tabs, what else? Social media. Sometimes you want to be on TikTok or you want to go on Snapchat, Instagram. What else do we go on? YouTube. Okay, now we are on YouTube today, but about God. Well, other things are what? Money. People like money very much. Sometimes they put money ahead of God. That happens also. Sometimes you also have idols, you know, like musicians, actors, actresses, superheroes, somebody who you really, really like. Now, these things are not bad in themselves, but when you love them more than you love God, or when you put them ahead of God or things of God, then they become idols. Okay. And then today's lesson, we're going to learn something that is more about our actions, because we're learning about what to do. We've been learning that my God is awesome, and that's very nice. But that's not just all. We can't keep singing and saying, God is awesome, God is awesome. We also have to show it. And there's someone who teaches us this. Our topic for today is called salt and light. And it comes from Matthew chapter 5, verse 13, all the way to 16. Now, this is a lesson we're learning from Jesus, and he's teaching us to be salt and light. Now let's start. Have you reached there? Matthew is very easy to find. It's the first book in the New Testament, right? So chapter 5, verse 13, we start, okay? You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled by men. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. So that's our reading for today. And Jesus tells us that we are the salt of the earth and the light of the world. When he says we are salt of the earth, he doesn't mean that we become salt like Lot's wife. No. What salt does is, let's look at what salt is. Salt is something which, when you put into something, it changes it. Like if you put salt in salty water, you put salt in water, it becomes salty water. If you put salt in fries, they become very delicious, even more delicious than they were before. If you put salt in what? In a wound, like let's say you cut yourself and you're bleeding, you put some salt. Now this one you have to ask an adult to help you. The bleeding actually stops, all right? So salt is very important. It's used for drying things. It's used for making things not go bad. Things like fish, they used to use, in the olden days, they used to use salt to make fish last longer. So salt is very, very important. So when Jesus calls you the salt of the earth, what does he mean? Let's look at also salty. What would you like that is salty? You like salted crisps, I'm sure you like that. Of course, we've already said chips or fries. Really, really like. I like salted caramel ice cream. It's delicious. Have you ever had it? Or cake? Oh, sorry, I digress. Back to the word. Teacher Judy is getting confused. Corona issue, we go and eat all the salty things we want to eat, right? Now, salt is very nice. It makes things delicious. That is why Jesus is calling you salt of the earth. You make the earth a better place. You want the world to be good? You want things to change around you? It begins with you. Salt is a source of influence. What influence means is that when you come into contact with salt, you change. So your actions can help other people change. The same way, you see, our last week's lesson was Elijah. Elijah brought people to worship God, right? So in the same way that people like Elijah, Moses, everybody made people realize that God is a true God, your actions can also make people praise God. And that's where now our memory verse comes. But before we even go to the memory verse, let's look at light. Why did Jesus say salt and light? What's the difference, right? So salt influences, right? You, the things you do make people change. Light is something which you see, like it's bright somewhere, and you say, wow, there's light. That is why Jesus says here, a city on a hill. Because if you see, if you're traveling somewhere and then you see a big house on a hill or a town on a hill, it's easy to see, especially at night now when the lights are full, all right? And then he also says that when you light a lamp, and imagine when it's dark, does mommy and daddy switch on the lamp and then they put it under the table or somewhere? No, they don't hide it. They put it out there so that it can give light to everyone. The world, let's be honest, is a bit dark and we need the light. And you, boys and girls, are the light that we need, all right? So when the light is switched on, it shines for everyone to see, okay? How are you a light? By witnessing. Light means witness, because when you look, you see God. You see how awesome God is. You tell people about God. You encourage people, especially now during Corona time. Many people, your auntie, your father, your mother, your own siblings, maybe they're bored, maybe they're nervous, they're wondering how things are going to be. But you can be the light by telling them how awesome God is. Even if it doesn't look like it, God is still with them. But you are the light. That's why Jesus is telling you are the light now. And that's why he says, you have the light in you, you are the light, let your light shine. And that's our memory verse. Matthew chapter 5, verse 16, it says, in the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your what? Good deeds, and praise your Father in heaven. Or glorify, some versions say, glorify your Father in heaven. So when they see your good deeds, they look, they say, wow. We praise God. You remember when Elijah did the great showdown? People didn't say, oh, Elijah is so cool, he's so good. No, they said, God, the Lord, he is God. So your good deeds are not about you, they are about getting God glorified. Okay, all right, that's good. So now, you are the salt, you are the light. And I know some of you, there's someone somewhere who's thinking, you know what, I want to be this salt, I want to be this light, I want to be part of this family of God the Father through Jesus Christ, and you want to accept Jesus as your personal Savior. So I want you to close your eyes, bow your head, and say this prayer with me. Dear Jesus, I know that I am a sinner, but I also know that you died for my sins, that I may be forgiven. So I come before you, I repent of my sins, and I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Be my guide, that I may be the salt of the earth and the light of the world. Amen. Amen. So now, if you made that prayer, welcome to the family. Well done. Congratulations. You clap for yourself, all right? So, we've learned a lot, and it's been interesting, salt and light. And if your mom and dad asks you, what did you learn? You'll say salt and light. But it's good to know that you're the salt and light, but do not forget to also put these things into action, all right? So now, salt does what? Influences, all right? Light does what? Witnesses. So your actions and your words, okay? Do not forget that. Those are our key issues, key lessons today, that your actions influence and your words bear witness to how awesome God is. You're the salt and the light, okay? Okay, now boys and girls, it's time to give. I know the details for giving are on the screen, so ask your parents or your guardian, whoever you're with, to help you with the giving. Don't forget, giving is an act of worship, so may God bless you as you give. And most importantly, don't forget, you are the salt of the earth and the light of the world. See you next week.
Wow, boys and girls, welcome to Fun Time. But did you enjoy the lessons for today about being the salt and the light of the earth? Yeah? I'm sure you enjoyed the lesson today. Shajudi, yes, how was the lesson?
It was nice. Do you remember the memory verse? Kobe, do you remember the memory verse?
Yes, teacher, I remember it.
Where was it coming from?
From the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 16.
16, well done. What does it say? In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father
in heaven.
Well done, well done. Speaking of Father, I have some riddles for you. Who feels like answering some?
Me, teacher.
Even me, I'm ready.
Even you're ready? Boys and girls, are you ready to answer some nice, nice riddles about fathers? Okay, now let me start. The first one is, my father was told not to cut my hair or give me any alcoholic drink. Drum roll. Do you know who that is?
Kobe,
do you know? Let me give you a clue. He was very strong, and he even fought a lion. He had long hair, and the day his hair was cut is when he lost his strength. That one is easy now, don't you think so?
Yeah. Kobe, do you want me to say, Emma, you have the answer?
Yeah, teacher, try first. I will laugh at you if you don't know.
I think it was Samson.
Well done, well done. Now, Kobe, I know you know Samson's father's name. What's Samson's father's name? Boys and girls, do you know? Shout it if you know it.
Manoah!
Well done, well done. Now, I'll do another one. My father was made mute, dumb. He was not able to speak until after I was born. That one is so easy. I won't even give you a clue. He couldn't speak from the day his birth was announced up to after he was born. The father could not say anything. He was, zip zero, saying, that one I know. Kobe, that is easy.
Yeah, I know the father.
You know the father?
But I think Kobe should say the person.
The person, yes. He is a voice that cries out in the desert.
Teacher, I know that.
You
know it. Yes. It is John the Baptist.
Well done, Kobe. Boys and girls, I hope you also got John the Baptist. Yes. And who is John the Baptist's father?
It was Zachariah, right?
Yes. Well done. Now, one last one. I'll make it easy because, well, this other sounded a bit hard. My father almost sacrificed me on a mountain. But then the angel of the Lord stopped him. Do you know who that is?
Teacher, I know.
Kobe, you know all the answers.
Yes.
Who is it?
I know that is Isaac.
And who's the father? Boys and girls, do you know? Easy. Father Abraham
had many sons, had many sons. Oh, Father Abraham, I am one of them, and so are you. So let us praise the Lord.
It's Abraham.
Yes, it is, Kobe. All right.
Well done, Kobe and Teacher Judy. But Teacher Judy, what are we doing about fathers? As in, we've done so many riddles about fathers.
Yes, because next Sunday is a special Sunday. Do you know what's happening next Sunday, Kobe? Do you have an idea?
No.
No?
Yeah.
Okay. Teacher Bonnie, do you have an idea? It's easy. It's about fathers.
I think it's about fathers. Can it be Father's Day?
Yes, it is. Next Sunday will be Father's Day. So what are we going to do? Teacher Bonnie is coming up with all these cool things that we can do. So what can boys and girls at home do? What can I do? What can Kobe do?
Yeah. I think I want to hear. Kobe, do you have an idea? I know, Kobe, you want to do something special for your daddy. Do you?
Yes, teacher.
So, you see, Kobe wants to do something special for his dad. So, even us, I want us to do something special for our daddies. Maybe a poem, or maybe write a card or do a video, whatever it is. kindly send us whatever you want to wish your father, and then we will display on our screens as we appreciate our fathers next Sunday. Yeah?
Looking forward to it. Ooh, I'm going to do something for my father. I know Teacher Bonnie won't put it, but I'm going to do something nice.
We'll try this time to put hers, yeah? We'll be fair because we're going to put Kobe's as well. Yeah, Kobe?
Yes, I'm going to do something very nice.
Good. And now we come to the end of our lesson today. I hope you are all blessed by the lesson for today. And I want us to pray. And before we pray, always remember to send us feedback of what you'd like us to improve or to change, and even your memory verses and what you learned today, kindly make sure you send that to us. All right, boys and girls?
Teacher,
thank you so much. Yes, Kobe.
I have one more thing I want to tell our parents, that mommy, daddy, to help us shine our light more, please help us go through the lessons we learn every Sunday throughout the week so that our light may shine more.
Nice. Awesome, awesome. Parents, kindly help us out. Okay, and let us pray now. Almighty and ever living Father, we thank you for such a great morning, O Jehovah God, that you have taught us how to be the light and even the salt of the earth. As we go out into a new week, O God, we pray that you may help us to shine our light in the midst of everything that is going around, even in our nation and even in our homes, O God, that will be boys and girls that stand out for what is right, O God. And Almighty Father, this morning, I bless every child listening to us this morning, that, oh Father, they will go out and be your disciples, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.